Hey guys, what's up? Well, Easter's coming up, so today I'm going to show you how to fold a new model I designed. It is, ta-da, an Easter egg. But not just any Easter egg, it's a magical Easter egg. Why? Because when you turn it slightly, it becomes a Peace-ter egg. Want to learn how to fold it? Ready, set, here goes. All right, so this model was folded from a sheet of, I don't know. This is paper that somebody gave to me. If anybody knows what it is, please let me know in the comments below. But I'm going to show you how to fold it from a sheet of 6-inch commie. So let's start white side up and valley fold diagonally in half. And unfold and rotate and fold diagonally in half in this direction. And unfold and now fold in half in this direction. And one more time, unfold, rotate, and fold in half in this direction. So in other words, fold in half in all directions. All right, now let's unfold and let's fold this edge to the middle crease. And unfold and rotate 90 degrees and fold this edge to the middle crease. And unfold and rotate and fold this edge to the middle crease. And unfold and don't rotate. Let's fold this edge to the crease. And unfold and rotate 90 degrees clockwise and fold this edge to the crease. And unfold and rotate 90 degrees clockwise and fold this edge to the crease. And unfold and rotate back this way. All right, now we're going to make a rabbit ear. We're going to make this fold and this fold at the same time and pinch the corner so it becomes a rabbit ear. And let's flatten it down like this. Okay, and let's do the same thing on this corner. So unfold it slightly and make both folds at the same time and flatten it down. Okay, now let's rotate 180 degrees and let's fold up right on the crease. And let's zoom in. And let's fold this edge onto this diagonal crease. And let's do the same thing on the left side, so fold this edge to the diagonal crease. And unfold, and unfold, and unfold. And now we're going to fold this corner up, and we're going to fold it up so that this edge is parallel to the crease and this edge originates right where this crease hits the side. So it's right there. And try to make this edge parallel to the crease. Okay? And let's do the same thing on the right side. So we're folding this flap up on this point. Like that. Okay, now let's fold this up so that this edge goes to this edge. And try to keep your hand in here, flattening it so that it doesn't slide up like that. We want to keep this flap pressed against the table. Okay, like that. And let's do the same thing on this side. We're folding this edge to this edge. Okay, and let's rotate like this. And let's fold this flap to the right. And let's fold this flap to the left. And now let's fold this flap in so that this edge aligns with this edge. that, and the same thing on the left side, so that this edge aligns with this edge. I'm gonna do a little minor adjustment here to just make them look a little bit nicer. You can adjust to taste. Okay, so there is the peace sign, and now we're going to do a swivel fold. What we're going to do is try to make this edge perpendicular to these lines right here. So what you're going to do is just hold it and push it down. This becomes a valley fold, and you just want to squash it so that this edge is perpendicular. Again, I'm going to zoom in so you see it. It's like that. And let's do the same thing on this side. So you just take this edge and just pivot it about this point so that this is perpendicular to these two. And flatten. And now let's rotate. And let's fold this edge to this crease. Fold it to that crease. And unfold, and now fold this edge to the same crease. And let's rabbit ear it, both at the same time, and flatten it down. And flatten it to the left. And make it stick straight up, and open the pocket, and we're going to squash it down. Like that. Now, you could fold this inside like that, but that's the easy way. Or you could petal fold. If you know how to do a petal fold, then this might be a little bit nicer because you can hang it from this point right here. So what you want to do is you want to lift this up and fold these two edges to the center crease. If you don't know how to do a petal fold, I recommend learning how to fold a paper crane because there's a petal fold in there, and that'll help you. So what you do is you just petal fold this up like this. And fold it back down. And tuck it inside like that. So this can be something that you could hang your egg by. You could even make a hook like that and it could hang like this. But for now, let's just put it inside. All right, now we just need to round the egg to taste. So let's take these corners and just fold them in. Let's really fold this in so that it makes a nice oval egg shape. It's not exactly an oval. And this point can be folded in. And these two points fold in. Yeah, just kind of make it to taste. You can look from this side how we're coming. If you want, you can make it by mountain folds. That's looking pretty good. It is. And so when you turn it over, the peace sign disappears, and then you hold it up to the light, it reappears. So it's like this, and when you turn it over, it's like that. So when you hold it with the face up, you don't see the peace sign. But when you tilt it so that it's face down, the light shines through and it makes the peace egg. So there it is. All right, hope you guys enjoyed that, and peace out. Bye-bye.